application is from June to September. Now, even if you are graduating in May and you've not gotten your transcript till June, you can still apply. Anytime in 2021 that you are graduating, you can still apply. Electoral curiosity. So this is APO. These are the key words you should put in your personal statement or your statement of purpose. They would give you full resident support for 4 years. As an undergrad, this scholarship is specifically for Africans. I like scholarships that actually go specifically for Africans because you don't have a reason to get rejected. So listen to the countries: Algeria, Egypt, Libya, Morocco, Tunisia, Burkina Faso, Ethiopia, Ghana, Nigeria, Cote d'Ivoire, Uganda, Senegal, and Tanzania. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Miramus here. In today's video, I'm actually going to be bringing you top 5 Canadian scholarships. Yes, it's not only about like USA, Europe. I'm actually bringing top 5 Canadian scholarships for the 2021 and 2022 academic year. You already know we are in 2021, and if you fit into any of these criteria or you are eligible for any of these scholarships, I would say it's nice for you. It's actually important for you to go ahead and apply. And let's continue the conversation down in the comment section below. Kindly hit me up on Instagram or Facebook, or continue in the comment section or even my email if you have any comments to add to this video. Let's get straight into the video, shall we? In today's video, the very first scholarship I'll be talking about is brought to you by Education Canada, and it is called the Global Affairs Canada 2021 Scholarship. The Global Affairs Canada 2021 Scholarship. This scholarship is for undergrads and masters. So they have the undergraduate scholarship as well as the master's scholarship, no PhD. This scholarship is specifically for Africans. I like scholarships that actually go specifically for Africans because you don't have a reason to get rejected. Scholarships that are broadly for international students are open to all over the world. So you get students from India, students from China, and then the competition is very, very high. But when it's specifically for Africans, I don't think the competition is that high. You know, it is high competition, but it's not that high because of the sample space is low, and then it's just like Africans and it's wee basically. So the countries that they are targeting is only specific African countries. So this scholarship, that's why I'm making it number one, because it's been streamlined for Africans. I'm actually excited about this scholarship. Listen to the countries: Algeria, Egypt, Libya, Morocco, Tunisia, Burkina Faso, Ethiopia, Ghana, Nigeria, Cote d'Ivoire, Uganda, Senegal, and Tanzania. Let me say that one more time: Algeria, Egypt, Libya, Morocco, Tunisia, Burkina Faso, Ethiopia, Ghana, Nigeria, Cote d'Ivoire, Uganda, Senegal, and Tanzania. If you are a citizen of any of these countries, please, what are you waiting for? If you are eligible for any of these, kindly apply. Now, they need you to not have schooled in Canada before, and they would be giving stipend of $10,200 Canadian for the undergrads and $12,700 Canadian for the master's program, people who actually get into the program. They would refund your visa fees. They will refund your airfare. They would give you health insurance. They will give you book stipends. They will give you your transportation allowance, and they will give you living. Now, this is an online application only. Obviously, because they've specifically listed the countries that they are interested in, they need you to prove that you are a citizen of that country. So if you, obviously, you need to have your passport ready or a form of identification, and you need to have your letters of intent, personal statement, and all of those documents that they require for scholarships and everything. So this is by the Education Canada. It is the Global Affairs Canada 2021 scholarship, and then the deadline is 30th March this month. We'll hear back from them in June 2021. Decided to open up this video with this scholarship and put it out there for people who are eligible to please apply. The second scholarship that I'll be talking about is the University of Toronto International Admission Scholarship for 2021. University of Toronto International Admission Scholarship for 2021. They are targeting only undergrads, and it's for international students. Like I said previously, when an application or when a scholarship is for international students, like everybody but Canadians are eligible to apply. So it's like there's a huge inflow of applications. But when it's specifically to Africans, there would still be a like huge inflow, but it's obviously not going to be as much as when it's for all general international students. So I would really urge you guys to apply to these scholarships as soon as you can if you are eligible. I need you to apply to the University of Toronto first before you apply for the scholarship. And the specific scholarship is called University of Toronto Lester B. Pearson International Fellowship. So as soon as you apply to the University of Toronto and you get in, you need to search under the website for the University of Toronto Lester B. Pearson International Scholarship to get tuition, books, and incidental fees attached to the scholarship. So they need you to apply the regular way by going online to the University of Toronto. Obviously, I'll be leaving the link on the screen and in the description box below for the specific link. So I actually went to search. I remember I went to search for the Lester B. Pearson International Scholarship, and then I went to search for the applications webpage as well. And I'm going to be leaving both links in the description box, so you can click on any of them during your any point in time of your application to apply when the time is right. They would give you full resident support for 4 years. As an undergrad, most undergrad studies are for 4 years, and they are willing to provide you full resident support for 4 years, exclusive to international students, like I already said. So this scholarship is actually ongoing, but then it's ending in April, specifically 30th April. So it's kind of nice to go ahead and apply as soon as you can. The third scholarship I'll be talking about is the Ivy Global Leader Scholarship Award, and it's from the Ivy University in Canada, and it's a fully funded scholarship for only international students. But this is for graduate programs only, so unfortunately those who are undergrads cannot apply. And I believe it is for masters. It says graduate programs, but I'm not sure if they accept people who are interested in pursuing a PhD. But I believe it's for masters only. But you can click on the link to check and be kind of sure. But I'm pretty sure it's for masters only. And then it's not open to all disciplines. They only want students who are interested in studying business administration or business management. So they need people who want to have graduate education in business administration or business management. They need you to have a GMAT. I believe people who do business related courses, when it's for grad school, you need to do the GMAT to get in, like MBA and those things. They need the GMAT and stuff. So this actually requires you to the regular scholarship requirements, your transcript, your resume. We made a video to distinguish between resume and CV. I'll leave it in the description box for you to watch. So please watch that video to know the difference between the resume and CV, because they say they want a resume. And then they need you to have 2 to 3. I would say when they say 2 to 3, it's best if you give them 3, just in case. So they want 2 to 3 letters of recommendation. We made a video on how to get a great letter of recommendation. I'll be leaving that also in link up, so you can actually check out that video as well. So this is the Ivy University in Canada Global Scholarship Award, and it's going to be ending April 12th. The fourth scholarship is from the University of Fraser Valley. The University of Fraser Valley International Excellence Entrance Scholarship. The University of Fraser Valley International Excellence Entrance Scholarship. It is very competitive. Now this scholarship specifically say they want you to have above 3.5 on a 4.0 scale GPA. Now I spoke about Scholaro the last time. Those of you who don't have up to 3.5 can actually input your credentials or your transcript in the Scholaro website to convert your GPA. Scholaro doesn't change your GPA, simply converts it to the US or Canadian standard. So if you know you have like a 3.3 or 3.4 or even 3.2, it depends. You can input your transcript details into the Scholaro website to kind of see if it's converted to the Canadian standard. Perhaps it's going to be above 3.5, then you can apply. It's very competitive. They're opening this to grad and undergrads, and you need to first enroll into the University of Fraser Valley, and they said they want people who have a GPA of over 3.5. The statement of purpose should show strong communication and leadership skills. So they need your personal statement of purpose to show strong communication and leadership skills. And they need a personal statement. Now, this is very tricky because they need a statement of purpose and they need a personal statement that shows strong communication and leadership skills. I remember we made a video with Dr. Mercy Ejiapon where she's talking about how even the littlest things you've done can be worded properly into strong leadership skills, strong communication skills. If you want, you can go check out that video. Of course, I'll be leaving the link up here where you can see, because Dr. Ejiapon is a faculty in New York University, NYU, and she talks about stuff that she would be looking out for because she recruits for her department as well. You really want to check out that video to know how to write a very compelling, strong statement of purpose that is really competitive as well. The deadline for this scholarship is May 1st, so you have a lot of time to kind of get your document ready if you are interested in applying to the University of Fraser Valley for the International Excellence Entrance Scholarship. The fifth scholarship that I will be adding is the McGill University McCall McBain School Scholarship. Wow. McGill University McCall McBain Scholarship. That's a mouthful. This is a full scholarship. I have been hearing McGill Scholarship, McGill. It's actually a very good scholarship and it's very competitive because I know quite a number of Africans that have gotten into this McGill Scholarship. So this McGill Scholarship is a full scholarship and they provide you with $2,000 per month as stipend. And then they need you to apply to the master's program or professional program, which means they are not taking undergrads, it's only for grad school. So they need you to apply to the master's program or the professional program. There are 60 awards to be given. So it's very, very competitive because it is open to Canadians and international students. This one is very competitive because plenty applications are just gonna be chow. Plenty applications. It's competitive because it's open to domestic and international students. Now they are making you understand that even if you are graduating this year, which is even if you are graduating in 2021, you can still apply. Because you, when you apply in 2021, you are getting in 2022. And the application is from June to September. Now, even if you are graduating in May and you've not gotten your transcript till June, you can still apply. Anytime in 2021 that you are graduating, you can still apply. Because at the end of the day, you are applying, so next year you move. We move. Even if you are graduating this year, which is in 2021, you can still apply because you'd have to start in 2022. You need to check out the link below to join their virtual meetings. They are having virtual meetings from March 16th to May 21 via Zoom. And these virtual meetings is like a question and answer session where they talk to prospective students about what the scholarship is about. I think they hold it every month, one every month or two every month. But you need to click on the link to be sure. And if you can, you join any of the virtual meetings, and if you have a question specific to your situation, you can always ask whoever would be representing the school during each of these meetings. So you get a clear idea of what the requirements are. Like I said, this McGill University McCall McBain Scholarship starts in June and it ends in September 2021 for you to apply and get in 2022. I want to give like a couple of tips those who have stayed up to this moment. Thank you guys for staying up to this time. One thing I realized in all of this Canadian scholarship is when I read into the application materials, they want your statement of purpose or your statement, your personal statement, to have people who have exceptional character, good community engagement, leadership potential, entrepreneurial spirit, and academic strength with intellectual curiosity. I think these are the key words: exceptional character, community engagement, leadership potential, entrepreneurial spirit, academic strength, and intellectual curiosity. So this is APO. These are the key words you should put in your personal statement or your statement of purpose, depending on what they are requesting for you to actually succeed and get in. So guys, this is the end of the video. I really hope this helps. I really hope this goes a long way to helping whoever is interested in studying in Canada 2021 or 2022. Thank you guys for staying till this moment, and catch you guys in my next video. Bye.